Hello everyone, this is me Sadia here and I'm doing your third week of May reading starting from the 15th through the 21st of May 2019. This is going to be for the sign of Gemini. So let's see what's coming up for Gemini for the third week of May. I'm going to use the same format for this reading as well as I did for the last two readings of the May. So yeah, let's see what's coming up with Gemini is. For the third week starting from tomorrow. Be mindful of the fact it is a general reading. It may not resonate with everyone out there. So pick whatever resonates and leave the rest. You can always reach out to me for a personal reading. You can also check out my Instagram page where I do upload daily readings every day. So yeah, you can follow me there as well. You can always reach out to me for a personal reading. And you can always check out the affirmation set that I offer, which help people to get rid of their subconscious blocks, because and they work really fast because they are spiritually charged. So yeah, if you are interested to get your set of affirmations done, you can always reach out to me for that, or you can reach out to me for further information on that as well. So yeah, let's begin the reading and let's see what is it coming up for the Geminis for the third week of May. I'm gonna start with this secret language of color cards. Coral, allow flow and synchronicity in your life. You can wear the stone coral during the second week of May. You can also wear this peachy orange color, which is going to keep you or help you keep synchronized, or your life, and for that matter of fact as well. Even though I don't see you struggling to let the flow of, or just let the flow of the universe flow through and to you as well, but for those of you who are going to have the challenges, letting things happen or letting go of things, trying to control every situation in your life, do incorporate this color in your life, which is going to help you let go of the situations as well. For those of you who try to control situations, or if you have somebody else in your life who is trying to control your life or your situation, I would suggest you to keep meditating to keep yourself protected from that influence coming from the third person, situation, or any, it could be anybody or anyone who would be trying to kind of sabotage the flow of abundance coming in your life. So to keep that flowing, you can wear the gemstone coral as well. For others of you, you could just protect yourself or the energy around you and in the house to stay protected from the influence of the other persons in your life. And you can also keep your things, your personal life personal, so you don't have other people interfering in your life. And you can do the same, you stop interfering in other people's life, because that's also one way you can stop people from interfering in your life as well. So let's see, wedding. Wow, this situation involves marriage. If you are planning to get married, if you are, if wedding is on the plans for you right now for the third week of May, if you are, thinking to take your relationship to the next level, like I said, try to keep your things personal or private until and unless it's out there or it's ready to be discussed or shared with people around you, because there might be some sort of interference that could come, which you need to protect this whole situation from. So just keep it, keep the privacy of this situation intact until and unless it's time for you to share the news with your close friends or family. Just try to keep it as personal as you could, as private as you could, until and unless it's time for you to share the news about your wedding with the people around you, to keep it protected. So let's see what the Rider Waite cards has to say. Three of Cups paired up with The Hierophant. Wow. Somebody is definitely getting married. Wow. It's perfect. But just try to keep the, you know, just try to keep the protection intact. I do see lots of celebrations happening for you for the third week of May. You might be having lots of gatherings, parties coming up because of this, you know, either you would be getting engaged or you would be having lots of, you know, family gatherings or get-togethers where you are going to be either planning for your marriage, where you are going to be either, you know, meeting the person, the person's family or something like that. There are going to be, you know, situations around the wedding which you are going to be having in your life. But as I mentioned, seeing this card here, allow the flow. And to allow the flow, you really need to have to block a few people out of your life so you could let the flow of abundance coming and, you know, flowing through you as well. So it's more of just try to keep the negative people away from you and negative situations, avoid negative situations as well. Like, you know, if you're planning for your wedding and if people, it's more like, you know, the energies could be around, you know, the wedding plans. Maybe somebody has some other plan for your marriage, but you don't like it. So it's more of don't try to push your idea of, you know, the whole wedding too much. Let things be as likely they could be, because if you try to force things can get like a bit you know, messy. And I'm sure you don't want to spoil the whole wedding plan for you, for yourself, for your family, and you know, for the people involved. Just to keep it, you know, in the flow, just to keep everything going smoothly, you really need to let things happen. Like, don't try to you know, it's more like, you know, I know if you are the one who is getting married in the family and it's like, you know, you have certain plans for your wedding and you really want the wedding to be done exactly the way you always want it to be. But I do pick up that somebody might be interfering in the situation and might try to, you know, twist a situation against you, or, you know, to go against your plans. Let them do it, because it's not going to affect you negatively. But if you resist the change, which is, you know, they want to bring in this particular situation regarding your wedding, you could end up getting they can't, you know, damage you. They can't damage the, you know, situation. But there might be, you know, a little bit of argument which you can definitely avoid by letting them plan exactly they want to plan. Like, you know, you can put your idea of how you want it to be, but if they want to go with another idea, let them do it, because at the end of the day, you are getting married to this particular person who you wanted to get married to. So let it go smoothly, just let things happen. Don't try to control things, don't be strict when it comes to you having your particular ideas to be, you know, implemented in this particular situation, because the time is not right. If you are going to resist the change, things are not going to get exactly the way you want. They can turn a bit, you know, not negative, that negative that would affect you in a bad way, but just let it go smoothly is all I can, you know, emphasize on. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for the third week of May. If the reading resonates with you, do like, subscribe and share. And if you're willing to get a personal reading in this particular situation, reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box. Till I do the next reading for you people, take care, bye-bye, and enjoy the wedding.